I would often be acting as an interpreter. So Stephen would say something, and if the person he's speaking to couldn't understand, I would then repeat it.
Although I was becoming increasingly trapped inside my dysfunctioning body, fortunately my mind was unaffected. I had a new big question I felt compelled to find the answer to. My reputation in the field of black holes was established as we entered a golden age. But my next discovery would throw all of cosmologists' findings to date up in the air. The calculations I was working on involved what happened to particles on the edge of a black hole that were sucked in and disappeared. To my great surprise, I found that some particles could escape the black hole, which seemed to make a mockery of the known laws of physics. At first I thought this must be a mistake.
I do remember when he was working on this problem, and indeed I even remember when he told me he was working out the quantum effects of these black holes, and he seemed to be getting this flux of particles coming out. When Stephen's thinking about a problem, he will become obviously obsessed with it.
It was a very intense period. It was when he could be surrounded by children and not notice what was going on, because he was like Rodin's thinker with his head in his hands, often accompanied by Wagner blaring out from the loudspeakers. He used to drive me spare.
Finally, after months of exhaustive work, I found what I was looking for. Contrary to all previously held theories on black holes, I discovered that they must emit particles like a hot body losing heat. This evaporation meant, in theory, a black hole could eventually disappear. I announced my findings on St. Valentine's Day in 1974 at a cosmology conference in Oxford to a packed audience.
He came to an end, and there was absolute silence in the lecture hall. And I can see it now. The chairman of the lecture jumped to his feet, and instead of saying, "Oh, I must thank Professor Hawking for his remarkable lecture," he said, "This is preposterous. I've never heard anything like it." The whole place was abuzz. People couldn't believe what they had heard.
My controversial discovery initially shocked the world of physics, but eventually it became accepted and known as Hawking radiation. I am proud to have discovered it.
This was a remarkably important result because it was a result which unified relativity theory and quantum theory and thermodynamics. And physics is really all about unifying ideas.
These three subjects seemed to be brought together, and this was the first time we'd seen that kind of unification.
Every now and then in physics, you get a result which is, it's so beautiful, it really is like rolling candy on the tongue.
Oh, I was enormously proud of what Stephen had achieved.
After I announced my theory of Hawking radiation and the later discovery of exploding black holes, a procession of international awards followed. In the spring of 1974, I was inducted into the Royal Society, one of the most prestigious bodies of scientists. My name now sat alongside Isaac Newton and Charles Darwin. A year later, I received the gold medal for science from Pope Paul VI. Age 32, I was...